I'm probably getting rid of Google Calendar. Not exactly, kind of, sort of. Let's look at what I'm talking about. So if we go into this app called Morgen.so, on the website you can see it's the most powerful calendar app. And this is essentially a calendar aggregator that also has task functionality, a schedule link just like Calendly and TidyCal, and actually can be 100% free. So if we go into the feature set that it talks about here by seeing the pricing, you'll see that it's really a possibility to use the task functionality and not have like the integration piece, and it'd be 100% free. So one calendar account. So in Google Calendar, something unique is that if you actually had multiple calendars, you could like subscribe to that one Google Calendar and then import your Google Calendar account that has those multiple ones added there. And then you would actually get all of your calendars at once. So yes, there is a $4 a month option for this app, and it's the cheapest one that I've seen for a calendar tool by far. And there's also a referral program so that you can get months off for free by having other people sign up. So it's really awesome that you can do things like have all this opportunity for free with a recurrent scheduling link with unlimited hours, similar to Calendly, unlimited one-time dueling links, which allows you to send a link for others to book an available slot in your calendar, and then unlimited tasks and task lists. And there are also a fair amount of shortcuts in the application, which I'll dive right into. So really quickly getting into this calendar, as can be seen, if I go to my account on the top right here, I have my admin at Rise Productive account connected to it. And what I actually did is I connected the Rise Productive one here, and I had connected my personal account, which had like all of the different parts of my life here. But from a color coding standpoint, you're not able to color code with things on the exact same calendar. So I just ended up making more calendars. And then from there, having the different parts of my life be sectioned off and calendared with new color schemes. Because the way that you can edit these colors is by going to manage calendars on the top right there, and then clicking through and changing it. But if they were all coming from this one, they would have all been blue. And I kind of like having different types of things in my life, like working out and actual work and just your day-to-day activities be different. And I even like to have what I call Calendly meetings, but are just like anything that's on my calendar that has a meeting, a different color than my Rise Productive work. But I could easily, if I wanted to, change that to a different color like this so that it's more in line with the red pink situation for Rise Productive on my calendar. And the way that this calendar works is very similar to any other calendar app that you have, where you just left click and drag, and then it adds a block here, change the name, and then you can click on this and you can pick what different calendar it's on under the same account, or if you have multiple accounts, and then it would change the color. And then you have the option to have the repeats picked here every day, every week, every year. So I could put every Monday, and then if you do every and just type in every, it'll end up giving you the custom prompt here to show like every how many weeks, daily, weekly, monthly. And then if you once again go and type every in here and do day or something to that effect, then you have the ability to just like custom edit it, and it'll be really friendly to you if you just do natural language processing and try to edit it. There's an ends time, there's an after how many choices time, very similar to Google Calendar. And then if you don't want to end up having this be a calendar event but more so a task, you can actually click this and convert it into a task like this. So tasks are a completely different thing in this application. If I take this off, it will still show up on the calendar, but if I want to get rid of it, I can right click and delete it. And then you have the choice to delete the task entirely or just unschedule it, and then it'll move into your task section. I'm going to press unschedule only. And what you'll see here, if I go right over here, is that we have a task list. So if I drag this guy as an example and then delete the event, it'll ask me the same thing. Do I want to delete or unschedule it? Just want to unschedule it, and that'll bring it right back to the task list. So this is something interesting that you can have if you really want to have recurring tasks at specific times. You actually can have this be a decent task management app for you. Now, I know a lot of people go back and forth on whether recurring tasks matter for them, but if they do it during specific time blocks, like I have with my Dimitri RP stuff in the morning, you really can get them to work really well for you. So say, for example, I took a video recording one from this Rise Productive section, and I were to color this the same color as I had with the calendar. So I can go here, manage calendars, go to Rise Productive, copy this code, go to Rise Productive, paste the code. Okay, so it's the same color. Then I would take this guy and move this to about when I'm doing it and drag it for a little bit longer of a period of time, let's say, for example. Then I put it right here. And then if I wanted to, You can double click on this. Then you have the option to do the same repeat situation, but only when it's on the calendar. You can't actually add a task and do a recurring situation on here. You have to manage it from the calendars. Can be seen, Morgan tasks can be made recurrent once they are planned on the calendar. Drag the task in the all day section or at a specific time. So you can take something like, if I took this and did reply to comments and dragged it to today, then dragged it onto the calendar, then changed it to an all day task, then you'd actually have your tasks at the top of here. And I'm not sure whether this is something that I would have a bunch of tasks for, but it is decent and could be an option for people who want to have it like that for recurring tasks that are just done at some point throughout the day. So then if I double click on this, I could have it repeat every week. And then if I press save, you'll see it'll be at the exact same time next week, which I think is actually pretty decent. You have a time blocking entire calendar app with Calendly links, integrations, as can be seen here. You can actually take your ToDoIst task. So if you're paying for that, you could do recurring tasks there and then just have it import here like a daily planner application would. There are different sorting options and only showing different things, like I could only show side hustle and then sort it by whatever order that I want by manually changing it or sorting it by due dates. And it shows multiple different types of priority here, like priority low, medium, and high. So this is just, I mean, this is some decently high level stuff. You got no priority for like P4, it's like P1, P2, P3, P4. Very similar to what you have in ToDoIst. And the purpose of having a bunch of different apps now with Morgan is kind of questionable. Like, do you need a calendar app and a task app? Now, it doesn't have a mobile app, so that's the one slide I do have on it. But it is an option for those of us who do most of our task management and calendar management from our computer. And if you do other really good productive things from your computer, check out this video to see how you can improve your productivity even more.